Mr. President, with the permission of the body, we take this privileged speech up and I ask that we recognize, Mr. President, the distinguished gentleman from the province of Isabela, Davao, and the Republic of the Philippines, Senator Rafi Tulfo, to deliver his privileged speech.
The distinguished gentleman from Isabela, may kababayan, Senator Rafi Tulfo is recognized.
Thank you, Mr. President. Good afternoon, Mr. President, my dear colleagues. Nandito po ulit ako sa harap ninyo at kinakalampag ang mga dapat magising dahil sa nangyayari sa mga kawawang manggagawa natin. Mga hamak na kahera ng empleyado ng Landmark ay lumapit po sa akin upang matugunan ang kanilang problema. My dear colleagues, inasmuch as I would like to say that there is no need for me to bring this to everyone's attention, the truth is, it is very much needed. I tried to help them and address their concerns outside these halls, but it seems that these employees did not have merit the attention of the company they work for. It all started with the post of Erica Joy Bendicho that went viral online and concerned netizens called my attention to intervene. I invited Erica Joy to my program and she explained what happened to her. She is a cashier at Landmark Makati. On her third day at work, she got the surprise of her life when her supervisor called her attention that there was a short in her cash turnover the previous day, amounting to 4,993 pesos and 71 cents. She tried to explain her transactions to her supervisor, but was still accused of taking the amount. The security officer interrogating her was forcing her to admit that she took the amount. Personal information about her family was being used against her to establish that she is poor and therefore in dire need of money. That's why she took the amount. I was surprised by this practice. From what I know, when it comes to these kinds of establishments, the transactions are checked at the end of the day in the presence of the cashier to make sure that things are balanced. Erica Joy asked for the computation and documents that would prove her shortage, but was told that the accounting documents are confidential. Concerned for his safety, because of the intimidating behavior of security officer Juanito Tanod, she signed a blank document and effectively waived whatever salary she had and even paid an additional 500 pesos to cover the supposed short she had. Ang nakaka-high blood po, dito lumabas ni si Erica Joy pa po ang nagbayad sa Landmark. Sa halip na siya po dapat ang pinasalduhan ng Landmark. Excuse me. Erica Joy told her story online and a lot of Landmark employees reached out to her who experienced the same thing. There were about 28, I repeat, 28 more stories similar to Erica Joy. Appalled by what she told me, I invited those who suffered the same fate to come to my office so that I could find out the nature and magnitude of this modus operandi. Honestly, I wanted to give the owners of Landmark the benefit of the doubt because this might be an isolated incident of a few unscrupulous managers and supervisors. Sad to say, this was not an isolated case. A few days later, several more cashiers approached my office. 8 more employees of Landmark with the same story. All cashiers being accused of shortage in their turnover. Lahat po sila pare-pareho ang kwento. After a few days, minsan isang linggo pa ang inaabot bago sila sinasabihan na nag-short. And when they confront management of the basis for the shortage, they are told that the documents are confidential. They are not even provided a calculator while they are being asked about the computation. And they are forced to sign a cashier shortage report waiving their salaries in order to cover the supposed alleged shortage. Excuse me. And sometimes, if they do not sign the said document because they are insisting that they did not take any money, the amount is still deducted from their salary. Nasaan po ang due process sa establishmentong ito? Ang takot na manggagawa na iniisip na sila ay makukulong kung di nila sasagutin ang nawawalang pera ay napipilitan pong magbayad. Bakit napapabayaan ang ganitong kalakaran? Bakit walang maayos na proseso ang pag-turnover ng pera para maprotektahan ang mga kawawang kahera? May isang mapalad na kahera na lumapit sa dole at inireport ang pangyari. Matapos lang isang conference, lo and behold, hindi natuloy ang pagkaltas sa kanyang sweldo. Ito ang aking pinagtataka. Kung ito ay nadole na, bakit di pa rin naayos ng management? At bakit hindi na imbisigahan dole? Bakit pa ulit-ulit pa rin nangyari ito sa mga kahera nila? Isang nakapagtakang kwento ng mga kahera ay nangyari ang mga insidente ng shortage tuwing nalalapit na ang sweldo o di kaya tuwing malapit na matapos ang kanilang 6 na buwan sa kumpanya. Kung sino ang... Sorry po, Mr. President. Kahit sino na makakarinig ng kwento na ito, walang ibang isipin kung hindi ito isolated incident. It is bordering on a practice being implemented by the management. I'm not sure if it is the topmost management or only on the level of the branches of Landmark. But these cashiers that approach me are from Landmark Makati and Nuvali in Laguna. Is it possible that this is being used to go around the regularization of employees? It is highly improbable that the directors and officers of Landmark have not heard of this. So are they covering this up? Are they condoning the said practice? Itong Juanito tanod-tanod na ito na security officer ng Landmark na nireklamo ni Erica Joy at ng isang Norman Cabero na dinuro-duro at sinakal. Ulitin ko po, sinakal siya nung siya ay in-interrogate. Siya ay pinoprotektahan ng mga abogado ng Landmark. Sabi nila, may sakit sa puso ra po itong si tanod-tanod. Kaya, huwag na munang imbestigahan, baka ra po atakayin sa puso. Pero ayon kay Norman, si Juanito Tanod-Tanod ay malakas pa sa kalabaw at nandoon lang sa Landmark, nagtatrabaho at tangising-isi pa. Sa ngayon, ang mga kahera na ito ay lumapit po sa dole upang magsampa ng kaso. Ngayon lang sila lumapit dahil sa tulong ng aking opisina. Bakit? Kasi ang mga mahirap, walang sapat na pera para ituloy ang laban nila. Kung di ko sila inudyukan na maglakas loob na lumaban, lulunukin na lang nila ang kanilang sitwasyon na sila ay binasagang o binansagang magnanakaw at iyak na lang sila sa sweldong di nila nakuha kababayad sa mga na-short nila. One injustice should be enough to wake us up from our slumber because as legislators, we have to look after those who don't have the opportunity and courage to stand up and fight for their rights. I am suspecting that these incidents are not isolated to these cases and not isolated to Landmark. The powerful is always preying on the weak. We must put a stop to this. Kadalasan ang narinig po natin sa balita ay mga employer na ninanakawan ng mga manggagawa. Pero dito, baliktad po. Ang mga amo, ang amo, ang nagnanakaw sa mga tauhan. Kung tutusin, baka may dalawang pagnanakaw dito. Yung nawalang pera na na-short mula sa mga transaksyon at yung sweldo na kinuha sa kawawang kahera na napagbintangan. Kawalanghian at its finest. Extreme na pang-abuso sa mga maliliit nating walang kalaban-laban pobreng manggagawa. Minimum wage na nga ang sahod, ninanakaw pa. One thing I want to be reviewed is the liability of directors and officers for fraudulent schemes such as this. Our office is studying on how we can provide rebuttable presumption against management when circumstances of fraud are presented by the employees. This will ensure that management will be advised and take responsibility for the managers and supervisors they are putting in place. And again, more than ever, my proposal that there must be a way to ensure that employees can recover from the employers necessary. The cash bond that covers the money claims of employees for labor claims come to play upon appeal from the labor arbiter to the NLRC. How about before that? What protection do laborers have? We need to find a way for money claims of laborers to be covered by the employers, including the directors and officers, if there's bad faith on their part. I look forward to working with my esteemed colleagues, the chairman of the Committee on Labor, Senator Dingoy Stada. I hope that the rest of my colleagues can join me in this advocacy in protecting our laborers. Ang parati po sinasabi ng mga employers, if there's no work, there's no pay. Pero ang nangyari na ay there's no pay even if they work. Dapat tumatayo na po tayo para sa ating kawawang mga manggagawa. Walang ibang gagawa nito para sa kanila kundi tayo. Thank you, my dear colleagues. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Senator Rafi Tulfo, Majority Leader.
Yes, Mr. President, before I refer the speech of the distinguished gentleman, Senator Rafi Tulfo, I would just like to put on record that this is alarming, and we thank the gentleman for bringing this up. We have heard so many stories about our kababayans in malls, not only the ending endo scheme, including this particular new scheme, Mr. President. Sila pa yung pagbabayarin or papipirmahin ng waiver, etc. at their expense. And we really need to do something and protect the best interests of our workers. And so with that, Mr. President, I move that we refer the speech of the distinguished gentleman from Isabela, Davao, and Republic of the Philippines to the Committee on Labor, Employment, and Human Resources Development. I so move, Mr. President.
Is there an objection? There being none, so referred.